Hi there, guys. Lovely to be with you all again today. It's Friday, the 20th of April. The end of the week again. You'll be looking forward to your weekend. Hope you've had a good week. Some of you have been having your ups and your downs. That's life, isn't it? Keep smiling. Keep trusting. Keep going on. Don't give up. And good things are coming. Hope this weekend is a lovely weekend for you. Still a bit dull, we're still looking for the nice warm spring weather to come back. I don't know if it's going to come anytime soon. Maybe we'll have to wait till May. It's good again to see all your wee pictures and to see some of these lovely art pieces, your final piece for art. Keep posting your pictures, keep letting us know how you're getting on. Some of you have passed driving tests, some of you have passed theory tests, have had other successes, some of you have passed interviews for jobs and you're on the road to getting a job. So just be blessed and be encouraged. Thanks for all your wee comments and your wee messages of love. Got another lovely one this morning. It's always good to hear from you and to get your wee messages of support. Hope you're enjoying these wee videos. We'll maybe go on till the end of April and then have a wee break over the summer, but we'll still be keeping in touch with you from the odd wee post from time to time, and we'll still be watching to see what you're up to. We've got a wee verse in Proverbs today, Proverbs chapter 20 verse 21. It says, an inheritance quickly gained at the beginning will not be blessed at the end. Let me read it to you again and put it up on the screen. An inheritance quickly gained at the beginning will not be blessed at the end. It's simply a saying that, you know, if you get something too quickly, you'll not appreciate it, you know. A lot of people think, oh, if only I could win the lottery, then that'll be me made. Life will be good, life will be happy. Well, you know, it doesn't work that way, you know. You win the lottery and, well, other people that have won it and their lives really haven't taken a turn for the better. You know, we get something too quickly, a lot of money. I've got a wee picture, I'll put it up. Money doesn't grow on trees, you know. You have to work hard for it. You have to be patient. You have to make an effort. And of course, you have to be careful how you spend it as well. So many people, they suddenly get a windfall and they go and blow it on all these useless things, you know, and then they've got nothing left instead of being careful with it. And that's what this wee verse is saying too. We get something really quickly, we just squander it, we don't appreciate it, and it flies away on wee wings, doesn't it? So we have to, God is teaching us here, you know. He's teaching us to be patient. He's teaching us to appreciate things. It's teaching us to grow up, and to be mature, and to have a mature view of money and of things. We all need money, of course. Money isn't evil in itself or bad. We all need money. We all need things. We need homes to live in. We need a chair to sit in. We need a light to shine upon us and that. We need a car to go around, and all these things are good and they're given to us by God, but God wants us to appreciate them and to keep them in the right place, in the right perspective, and never to allow things to squeeze God out of our lives and out of our thinking. And you know, we all love beautiful things, and I love beautiful things. I love a beautiful face, or a beautiful, looking at a beautiful home, or a beautiful car, or a beautiful suit, or a beautiful dress. You know, we look at beauty, and beauty does have an appeal, and it's good. But we have to be careful that we don't let beauty and beautiful things take our attention and our minds off God. He must have first place in our lives. We want to follow Jesus, and of course Jesus sets us an example, because he was always patient and he was always careful about things, putting God, his Father's will, first and not worried so much about money. Jesus was always generous, you know, generous with his time, generous with his giving, always telling the disciples to give to the poor and that, and he cared for them. And Jesus lived a simple life, you know. And even when he fed, you'll remember he fed the 5,000, and he told the disciples to pick up all the scraps, and they had 12 baskets full of pieces left over. And Jesus doesn't like waste, and Jesus appreciated little things. He often would teach from a little flower or a little seed that the farmer sowed, or a little lost sheep or a little lost coin. Jesus valued little things, and we need to value and appreciate little things. And sometimes we want everything, we want it right now. And you know that the banks are offering us credit cards and everything, and these are good in their place, of course, not decrying it, but you know, we just sometimes we have to wait and not buy the next thing that just comes out just because we want to feel good or we want to get one up on our pals. But just to be content with what we have, you know, and be content with all the good things that God gives us, and not always wanting more, 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 and not being greedy. God wants us to appreciate. And he says if we get it all too quickly, we'll not appreciate it. And another translation says, you know, we can get a bonanza, we can get a big win, or we can get a windfall. But he says there are no guarantees. There are no guarantees that it's going to do us any lasting good. And so it's better to be content. It's better to realize that money doesn't grow in trees, and to work hard and to wait and to be patient and to be kind. And instead of wanting the next best thing, instead of wanting that new phone, you know, why not be content with the one that you've got? And instead of wanting to spend all that money on yourself and something that you don't really need, if you're honest, what about thinking about giving some of your money away? Giving to charity, that's always good. But, you know, there might be somebody, you know, that's struggling in your street, you know, a wee lady, a wee single mom, or maybe struggling with a couple of kids. And wouldn't it be lovely? You could go down to the Asda and just buy her a nice bouquet, you know, take £5 that you would have wasted maybe on yourself, or maybe you'd have gone down and bought yourself a McDonald's. But instead of doing that, why not make a sacrifice? Why not think of someone else? Why not go and buy a nice bouquet and give it to an elderly couple that you know? Or give it to, or take it up to the hospital and visit somebody that you know that's sick, you know? Or buy a wee card and sign it and post it off to somebody thinking of you. You know, spend on others. And make smiles, you know. And if you give others a smile, the smile will always come back to you as well. And there'll be a smile on your face as well. So don't be greedy. Don't be selfish. Don't be stingy. Be generous. Be kind. Look for ways that you can help people. Look for ways that you can be kind, you know. Buy somebody's lunch today in the college canteen. Pay somebody's bus fare or train fare on the way home. You know, treat somebody to a taxi ride. You know, and there's so many things that you can do. Trixie and I had real fun giving away lots and lots of Easter eggs just over the Easter, just to see the smile. And teddies, we had lots of teddies. And just to see the smiles on so many faces, and it's brought a smile to our face, I can tell you. So it's always good to be generous. And you know, if you get too much too quickly, you'll not appreciate it. And God wants us to grow up and mature and to appreciate all the things, little things and big things, that he brings into our lives. Hey guys, thanks for watching today. Remember to put your trust in the Lord Jesus. He that believes has everlasting life. Make Jesus your Savior if you've not done it already. And this will be the best weekend that you've ever had. God bless you, and all being well, we'll see you on Monday. Bye for now.
Breath of heaven, hold me together. Be forever near me. Breath of heaven. heaven.